For me, the Quran always is a supremely egalitarian text. Yes, there are certain passages in the Quran that talks about certain supposed inequalities, but if you look at the overarching message of the Quran, it is one of equality, of gender parity. Now, if men are leaders of communities because they're competent, then similarly, when women are competent, they can be leaders of community. Leaders of community in society, in politics, and also in religion. Not only can they interpret the Quran and provide the commentaries necessary for the 21st century, but they can also lead prayers and take on the pastoral role and other functions of an imam. And there's no reason why a woman in the light of the Quran cannot do so. So we firmly believe that since the Quran's golden dictum is that whatever is not prohibited is permissible, and the Quran doesn't specifically prohibit women from leading. In fact, it mentions the Queen of Sheba in the most laudatory terms of a good and just and pious ruler. So that is enough for us to say that yes, a woman can, when she's competent, when she has the necessary knowledge, like a man, when a man has the necessary knowledge, that they can lead communities. So our idea is that to have a non-sexist, gender-equal mosque and center where women are part and parcel of the liturgy, of the sermons, of everything in this mosque and in the center. And for this reason, we will train women like we will train young men and the young women to become British imams for a British Muslim community and not for a Pakistan or Egyptian or Indonesian community. In other words, British imams, men and women, for British Muslims for tomorrow.
And this would be the first ever woman in the world to lead a mixed Muslim congregation, isn't that right?
We expect that it will be one of the first women to lead a mixed congregation on a permanent, durable basis, and we are very happy to make history. When we look at history, and we look at Emily Pankhurst, when she and other suffragists chained themselves to the railings of Parliament, yes, there were many women at that time who were opposed to the fact that they were making a spectacle of themselves. Yet today, it isn't a single woman that I know who is not indebted to the suffragists for bringing about franchise for the women. Similarly, for these women that we wish to train as imams to become leaders of the center of a British mosque, for a British society, for a British Islam, this will represent a massive step forward for our religion to become part and parcel of not only of Britain, but also of the 21st century.
Isn't this considered heresy by members of your community, and haven't some members already received threats?
The Quran is quite clear that no one can pronounce on the faith of another. Heresy is not a Quranically justified response. When the clergy embarks on takfir or excommunicating people, condemning them as heretics or apostates, they're acting contrary to the Quran. Yes, now if certain conservative Muslims like the Wahhabis, the Salafis, the Ikhwanis, the Diyabandis and others do not want Muslim women to be leaders of mosques, they are perfectly entitled to do so in their mosque. We will be perfectly entitled in our mosque to have whoever we wish, and if the best person is a woman to lead the prayers and she's the most knowledgeable, then we will act within the law of Islam, within the guidelines of the Quran, to have her there as our leader.